My dear students, this is a finite element method of fourth class. Already in last class we solved the sum of the problems. Now in this first topic I will explain two more problems on the two dimensional simplex element. Okay, here earlier classes we discussed some problems. Now we will discuss based on the load. Okay, now for a two dimensional, now I will read the problem, go through the my material. Already I loaded my material in WhatsApp group also, my dear students. Okay, certain times this material it is not available in your YouTube channel, that's why first of all download that material in WhatsApp group. Next you go through this particular topic in YouTube channel. Okay, for the two dimensional plate shown in figure, determine the deflection at the point of load application. Okay, now here they were mentioned simply, now we have to calculate the deflection at the point of load application. This is the two dimensional plane element is there. So they were mentioned 1, 2, 3 nodal points. Here this size is 30 mm, this length is the height is the 20 mm is there. And they were mentioned two forces. One is a horizontal positive direction force 500, that is towards right hand side we will consider positive. If it is the left hand side is there, we will take the negative sign. That's why I mentioned positive sign 500. But 1000 newton, this load is acting downward. I think you know very well this load is the negative load. That is the upward direction is the positive, downward is the negative is there. So, and thickness of the plate is a 10 mm. Material properties are Young's modulus are the 70 gigapascals and Poisson's ratio is the 0.3. Okay, this is the given information. Now we have to calculate the total deflection in our element. Okay, now first of all, for calculation of the deflections etc., that is now first of all we have to find the coordinate points. That is write down the coordinates at node 1. Its coordinates x1 is the 0, y1 is the 0. I am taking at this particular point as the origin, that is x axis in this direction and y axis in this direction. Okay, x2, y2 at node 2. This is the node 2 is there. x2, what is the dimension from this reference line to this particular distance? 30 mm. What is the height from the x axis to this particular point, second node point? 20 mm. That is x2 is 30, y2 is 20. Next, node 3. This is the node 3. That is x3 is less on y axis, that's why x3 is equal to 0. y3, this point is located at a height of 20 mm. So y3 is equal to 20 mm. Now we will calculate the area of the triangular element. This element, this is, if you are observing, this is a right angle triangle. You may apply the formula half into b into h, we will get the same area. But as per our finite element procedure, we are calculating half into determinant of 1 x1 y1, 1 x2 y2, 1 x3 y3. That is half into determinant of 1 0 0, 1 30 20, 1 0 20. I substituted these coordinate values here and expand that term. Now we will get that 300 mm². All dimensions are in terms of mm, so area is the 300 mm². Next, we have to calculate the strain displacement matrix B. So for that particular purpose, now we have to calculate the beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3. I think you know this particular relations already. While you are deriving the shape functions, we wrote the same type of things. That's why beta 1 is equal to y2 minus y3. Substitute this coordinate 20 minus 20, 0. Beta 2 is equal to y3 minus y1, that is 20 minus 0, 20. Beta 3 is equal to y1 minus y2, 0 minus 20, minus 20. Gamma 1 is equal to x3 minus x2, substitute that coordinates, 0 minus 30, minus 30. Gamma 2 is equal to x1 minus x3, that is 0 minus 0, that is equal to 0. Gamma 3 is equal to x2 minus x1, that is 30 minus 0, that is equal to 30. I think we know that strain displacement matrix B is equal to, already we derived the stress strain relationship matrix, that is a strain displacement matrix. B is equal to, what is the relation? 1 by 2a, beta 1 0, beta 2 0, beta 3 0, here 0 gamma 1, 0 gamma 2, 0 gamma 3, gamma 1, beta 1, gamma 2, beta 2, gamma 3, beta 3. Now you substitute all these values from the previous calculations. That is 1 by 2a, that is 2 into 300 is the 600, into beta 1, substitute beta 1, 0, beta 2 is the 20, 0, beta 3 is the minus 20, 0. 0, gamma 1, gamma 1 is the minus 30, 0, next gamma 2 is the 0, next 0, next gamma 3 is the 30. Next, here beta 1, minus 30, sorry, gamma 1, minus 30, beta 1, 0, next gamma 2, 0, beta 2, 20, next gamma 3, 30, here beta 3, minus 20. Now, we got the strain displacement matrix. Now, we have to calculate the displacement actually, our main aim, you know, we will calculate that one. That is a strain here, this one is the stress strain relationship matrix. This is not the strain displacement matrix, this is the stress strain relationship matrix. Unfortunately, I wrote the same here. This is the stress strain relationship matrix or constitutive matrix. Take correction, my dear students. Here now we will calculate the stress strain relationship matrix or constitutive matrix. That is here, that constitutive matrix D is equal to E by 1 minus mu square into 1 mu 0, mu 1 0, 0 0, 1 minus mu by 2. 1 minus mu by 2. That is, substitute all these particular values. That is 4 into 10 to the power of 4, the property of the Young's modulus, into 1 minus Poisson's ratio square, 0.3 square, and 1 mu, 0.30, 0.31, 0, 0, 0, 1 minus 0.3 by 2. That is here, simply here all these values, all these particular values I multiply with the 10. Then the final value is the 7 into 10 to the power of 5 divided by 91. Okay, into 10, 3, 0, 3, 10, 0, 0, 0, 3.5. Okay, next, stiffness matrix K is equal to, you know that relation, beta transpose, B transpose D into B into A into T. That is the stiffness matrix K is equal to, I wrote beta transpose as it is. Next, D matrix I wrote, and the next one is the, here B matrix. Into area is the 300 mm square, thickness of the element is the 10. Okay, next, now I wrote the beta transpose here. Now at present I substitute that beta transpose. When I am multiplying with this matrix and this one, I got a new matrix, that is a 0 minus 90, 20, 0 minus 29, 29, 0 minus 30, 6, 0 minus 6, 30, and so on. Okay. Now you multiply the remaining two matrices. If you multiply the remaining two matrices and this constant value, here we will get 10 to the power of 6 divided by 156 into, we will get a one new matrix, 6 by 6 stiffness matrix, that is a 31.5, 0, 0, minus 21, minus 31.5, 21, etc. This is a stiffness matrix. Okay. Now we have to find the displacement. That is, we know the basic finite element equation. What is that equation? Force is equal to stiffness into delta. Now, that is, I wrote the same equation here. Now, substitute that particular relation, K into delta. That is, here delta is the, actually U1, V1, U2, V2, U3, V3 is there. Directly, I wrote this particular step. And here, F is the F1X, F1Y, F2X, F2Y, F3X, F3Y. Okay, and after that, and applying the boundary condition, at the same time I applied the boundary condition. If you are observing, the node 1 is a fixed position is there, and the node 3 also fixed position. That's why that is, even heavy amount of load is there, that the deflection at node 1 and 3 is 0 only. That's why I substitute that boundary condition 0, 0, 0, 0. F1 and node 1 and node 3 are fixed points. That is the force vector. In that force vector, we will get a reaction forces we don't know that reaction process. That's why I wrote here. Otherwise, if you does not know that particular value, you may write simple zero also. But simply I wrote the same thing, f1x, f1y, f3x, f3y. But at node 2, they were mentioned the external forces in x direction, that is a positive direction, 500 is there. In y direction, that is in negative direction, that particular force is the minus 1000. Okay, now substitute. Now, after applying the boundary condition, what is the step? By using Gaussian elimination, eliminate the number of rows and number of columns which are zeros in displacement matrix. That is, in this particular first value is 0, second value is 0, and fifth value is 0, sixth value is also 0 in displacement matrix. You observe the displacement matrix, first value is 0, second value is 0, fifth value is 0, and sixth value is 0. That's why you strike out the first row, first column, second row, second column, and fifth row, this is the fifth row, fifth column, and sixth row, sixth column. You strike out these values by using Gaussian elimination. And the remaining vector, if you observe only this particular one, in front of this one, here actually one constant factor is there, 10 to the power of 6 divided by 156 into 400014, that is a U2V2 into here 500 minus 400. If you solve these two equations, we will get a displacement at node 2 in x direction as the 1.95 into 10 to the power of minus 3 mm, and in y direction is the minus 11.14 into 10 to the power of minus 3 mm. You may get certain doubts, sir, why you got the negative value? That is the negative value, V2 is the negative value, means what does it mean? The deflection takes place in downward direction. Why? Because the force is acting downward. Obviously, deflection also takes the downward. That's why here we got the negative value. So our problem is 100% true only. Okay, these are all the different types of problems we solved. And one more topic on the simplex element, that is the constant strain triangle element. Before going to the solving of the problem, now we will discuss some small theory concept. That is the temperature effects on CST element. Okay, my dear students, now we will discuss the one more topic. That is the temperature effects on CST element. I think in first unit, second unit, also we discussed the same type of temperature effect. That is, indirectly this name is a thermal effect. That is, whenever the temperature changes, automatically body tends to expand or takes the contraction. Due to this self-expansion or contraction, inside of the body it is subjected to the different types of stresses. That particular stresses generally we call as the thermal stresses or initial stresses. Due to the stress that element takes place, the strain value we consider as a thermal strain or initial strain. That it means here, without applying the any amount of external load, your body is subjected to a certain amount of expansion or contraction. That's why this one we call as the initial strain or thermal strain. Why you call thermal? Means due to the increasing or decreasing of the temperature only this effect takes place. That's why this one we call as the thermal strain. Okay, I think we already know the strain epsilon in general equation. That is, epsilon is equal to, we wrote that one as the epsilon x, epsilon y, gamma x, y. But here thermal is there, that's why we wrote this as the thermal strain is the epsilon suffix t. Epsilon suffix t x, that is strain in x direction, epsilon suffix t y, strain in y direction, gamma t x y, strain in x y plane. Okay, now here its relation, already in second unit we discussed the thermal strain is equal to here coefficient of, that is thermal strain is also same relation, change in length by original length only. Change in length, what is the change in length? L alpha delta t. We derived the same type of one in second unit. Remember, my dear students, L alpha delta t. L is the length of the element, alpha is the coefficient of expansion, it is the property of the material, delta t is the change in temperature. That is, a change in temperature means actually at room temperature, body does not take either expansion or contraction. Whenever the temperature increases beyond that room temperature or lower the room temperature, then only this type of problem will occur. That's why here we wrote the change in length is the L alpha delta t divided by original length is the L. If the LL term becomes cancelled, now the strain is the alpha delta T. Okay, this one is in plane stress condition. We have to remember this particular thing, very very important. Why? Because we are solving the plane problems, that is a 2D element problem. So here what condition we are solving? If the plane stress case is there, simply we will write. But in the case of plane strain, we will write that one is the 1 plus mu into same relation, alpha delta T 0. Okay, like that here, we'll first of all, we will find the strain values. Okay, the same notation here I mentioned here. Now, that is, if you want to, after knowing the stress, sorry, strain relation, you know the stress relation. As per the Hooke's law only, stress is directly proportional to the strain. So simply I wrote here, induced resultant stress is equal to, that is here instead of Young's modulus, here we wrote the stress strain relationship matrix or constitutive matrix, D matrix, into here you have to consider the two types of strains. Suppose if the body is subjected to an external load, you have to consider the strain value also, minus here you take the thermal strain also. You may get certain doubt, why you use the negative sign. Negative sign, that is that the load may be acting positive direction, strain may be due to the temperature, thermal strain may be acting in the another direction, that's why we've taken the negative sign. Suppose if both are positive is there, you take the positive sign only. Okay, so based on that one, that is the initial strain is there, that one we are rectifying, so here we taken the minus. Okay, D into epsilon D. What is the epsilon? This is the strain due to the mechanical loading. What is the mechanical loading? That is, external loads are acting on your element. Okay, external loads are acting on your element. Epsilon T is the thermal strain. Okay, that is equal to, you know that relation, D into strain. That is, strain due to the external load is the B into delta. B is the, what is this one? Strain displacement matrix into displacement matrix minus epsilon T. That is, if you multiply these two matrices, you will get the resultant matrix. What is the resultant matrix? Resultant stresses in x direction, normal stresses in x direction, resultant normal stresses in y direction, and resultant shear stress on xy plane. Okay, that is the strain also, we will write the, here epsilon is the, you may forget that way, that's why I wrote the same relation once again. Epsilon is equal to epsilon x, epsilon y, gamma xy. What is this one? Strain in x direction due to the external load. Strain in y direction due to the y direction, external load, sorry. In the same manner, gamma xy, that is a shear strain due to the external load. Okay, like that, here we will substitute all this particular relation. Now we will get the sigma r, if you want to calculate sigma r. In the same manner, if you want to calculate forces also, that is a forces. If the external forces are acting, that one we call as the mechanical forces. Simply we can write F is equal to, what is that particular one? And our Fx, external force is acting, we will write F1x, F1y, F2x, F2y, F3x, F3y, like that. But the temperature is acting, now we have to consider the thermal force value. That is, here earlier we wrote that particular relation. That's why by using that relation, thermal force is equal to, what is the thermal force relation? Stress into area, indirectly. By using such type of relation, here I wrote that one is the beta transpose into D into epsilon T into A into T, A into T. Okay, by using this particular relation, we will calculate the thermal force acting on the element. Okay, now here, you know that A is equal to area of the element, T is the thickness of the element. Thermal force or thermal load vector is equal to, that is, that one as the FT1x, FT1y, FT2x, FT2y, FT3x. What does it mean? Thermal force at node 1 in external load. Sorry. No, thermal force at node 1 in x direction. Thermal force at node 1 in y direction. Thermal force at node 2 in x direction. Thermal force at node 2 in y direction, and so on. Okay. So, after calculation of all these particular forces, here also we will take the resultant forces. This is the basic theory concept. Now we will solve one simple problem on thermal force vector. Okay, thermal forces. Now I will first of all I will read the problem, then we will try to solve the problem. Okay, now here this is the problem. Calculate the thermal force vector for the plane stress element shown in figure. The element experiences a 10 degree centigrade increases in temperature. Assume Young's modulus E is equal to 15 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton per centimeter square and Poisson's ratio mu is equal to 0.25. Coefficient of thermal expansion alpha is equal to 6 into 10 to the power of minus 6 centimeter per centimeter degree centigrade and thickness of the element D is the 0.5 centimeter. Also find the stress component for that element if the nodal displacements are U1 at node 1 displacement at node 1 x direction displacement is 0 and y direction displacement is 0, node 2 0.001 centimeter, U at node 2 y direction 0.0006 centimeter, at node 3 x direction U3 0.0004 centimeter, V3 is the minus 0.001 centimeter. This is the given problem. Okay. Just now we discussed the thermal force and thermal stress relations, that is due to the increasing or decreasing of temperature. In our problem, temperature increases to the 10 degree centigrade and they mention the coefficient of thermal expansion and displacement values, everything. Now simply we will calculate the thermal force and its stresses. Okay, my dear students, listen carefully. Now here, once again, I reconstructed the same diagram, the triangular element. I identify its coordinate points as x1, y1 and x2, y2, x3, y3. That are three coordinate points are 0, 0, 2, 0, 1, 3. Now, first of all, earlier how we solved the problem, in the same manner we will solve the problem. First of all, we will solve the area of the triangular element. A is equal to, as per the matrices relation, that is 1 by 2 determinant of 1 x1, y1, 1 x2, y2, 1 x3, y3. Substitute that coordinate values half into 1 x1 y1 0 0 1 x2 y2 2 comma 0 1 x3 y3 1 comma 3 1 3. If I expand this particular one, we will get area of the element as the 3 centimeters square. Okay, now we will calculate the sum of relations for strain displacement matrix. Okay, strain displacement matrix. Beta 1 is equal to y2 minus y3, that is 0 minus 3 minus 3. Beta 2 is equal to y3 minus y1, 3 minus 1, that is equal to 3. Beta 3 is equal to y1 minus y2, that is 0 minus 0, that is equal to 0. Gamma 1 is equal to x3 minus x2, 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. Gamma 2 is the x1 minus x3, 0 minus 1, that is equal to minus 1. Gamma 3 is equal to x2 minus x1, that is a 2 minus 0, that is equal to 2. I think you know that strain displacement relation. P is equal to 1 by 2a, beta 1 0, beta 2 0, beta 3 0, 0 gamma 1, 0 gamma 2, 0 gamma 3, gamma 1, gamma 2, beta 2, gamma 3, beta 3. Now substitute all these values in this particular matrix. If you substitute the values in this matrix, we will get a matrix, a strain displacement matrix, that is 1 by 6 into minus 3, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 2, minus 1, minus 3, minus 1, 3, 2, 0. Okay, we obtain the strain displacement matrix. Unfortunately, this page, I did not identify earlier. Here, this page is somewhat not visible clearly in my video. But all of you, my dear students, go through my material, definitely it is very clearly visible. That is here, if you are observing, for plane stress element, stress strain matrix, this is the stress strain matrix, D is equal to E by 1 minus mu square into 1 mu 0, mu 1 0, 0 0, 1 minus mu by 2. That is as per plane stress condition. Substitute the values. E is the 15 into 10 to the power of 6, 1 minus 0.25 square, 1 here, 0.25, 0, 0.25, 1, 0, 0, 0, that is 0.375, 1 minus 0.25 by 2, okay, 0.375. entire matrix, if you multiply with the 4, we will get the 4 into 10 to the power of 6 into 41014000 1.5. Okay. If required, suppose if this slide is not proper way, in WhatsApp material also, you may ask. Definitely, I will send the same page once again. Here, this one here somewhat it is not visible clearly. I will continue my class with the same page. If you required, and definitely we have to ask this one. Now, that is we calculate the D matrix. Then we will calculate the, as per the plane stress condition, we will calculate the thermal strain. Thermal strain. Epsilon T is equal to alpha delta T 0. Substitute alpha value and delta T. 6 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 10. 6 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 10, 0. That is, I taken 6 into 10 to the power of minus 5 term common, 1, 1, 0. That is, the thermal force vector Ft is equal to we know that B transpose D into epsilon T into area into thickness. Now, thermal matrix, vector force matrix is the Ft1x, Ft1y, Ft2x, Ft2y, Ft3x, Ft3y is equal to, first of all, B transpose I wrote as it is. Next, I substitute the D matrix and D and epsilon T, A, T. That is, the D matrix is the 4 into 10 to the power of 6 into 41014000 1.5 into 6 into 10 to the power of 5, 110 into 3 into 0.5. If you calculate these values, these two, that is, if you multiply these two matrices, we will get that is a 550. Now substitute the beta transpose. If you substitute the beta transpose and this constant value also, if you multiply this 4 into 10 to the power of 6 and 6 into 10 to the power of minus 5, 240 into this 3 into 0.5 is the 1.5 divided by beta transpose. B transpose 1 by 6 is there, so I wrote by 6 into that is a B transpose matrix I wrote here. That is a B transpose matrix is the minus 3, 0, 1, minus 1. 0 minus 1 minus 3, 3 0 minus 1, 0 minus 1, 3, 0 0 2, 0 2 0, and multiply these two values, these two matrices, and this one also. If you multiply, your force, thermal force vector becomes minus 900, minus 300, plus 900, minus 300, 0, 600. We'll get these values. Okay, this is the thermal force vector. Simply they are asking only thermal force vector. Why? Because in our problem they did not mention any external force, that's why we did not concentrate on the mechanical forces. Only simply we calculated the thermal forces. Okay, now we will go to the second bit. That is, find the element stresses. That is a sigma T. Element stresses. Now, element stresses means here also they were mentioned the displacement values. With respect to displacement values, now we have to calculate the thermal induced stress values. Okay, now listen, and that is, find the stress, that is, we know that delta is equal to u1 v1 u2 v2 u3 v3. Substitute the given displacement values: 00, 0.001, 0.006, 0.009, minus 0.001. Okay, and multiply the B into delta. B into delta. Already we calculate the B matrix and delta values. We know the delta values. That is 1 by 6 into this matrix. And I wrote the delta matrix. If you multiply these two matrices, we will get the 10 to the power of minus 5. 5 minus 43.33, 41.67. Okay. Now here. Now, if you substitute the B delta, this one is the external strain values and thermal strain values also you have to take. Thermal strain values already we calculate epsilon T. Now this one is the substitute that both the matrices 10 to the power of minus 5 minus 43.33 41.67 minus 10 to the power of minus 5 666. Sorry, this is the 0. This one is the 0. Okay, now if you subtracted these values from this particular matrix, we'll get 10 to the power of minus 5 is the common, minus 1, 49.33, 41.67. Resultant element stress is sigma r is equal to stress strain or constitutive matrix into this particular one. Once again, substitute that particular relation, already we calculated. Now we will get the if you multiply this one and these two matrices, we'll get minus 2133.2 and minus 7932.8 2500.4 Newton per centimeter square. That is, normal stress in x direction is minus 2133.2 Newton per centimeter square. Normal stress in y direction is minus 7932.8 Newton per centimeter square. Shear stress in xy plane, on xy plane is 2500.4 Newton per centimeter square. Like that we will solve the problem. Okay, now maximum problems also solved on this particular topic. I will stop this particular one here. Next class I will continue. Thank you.